When Maria Teresa Cabrera decided to run for president of her local teachers union, her opponent said that as a woman, she would be too busy washing her hair, fixing her nails, and putting on makeup to lead an important organization. Say what? What did he say again? That as a woman, she would be too worried about her makeup and would be too busy to be a true leader. And yes, Maria Teresa was busy, very busy, educating students, assisting teachers, reforming the classroom, listening to parents, organizing, working to improve schools, preparing her students for a better future. She was busy breaking stereotypes about women.
Quien competía conmigo era un hombre.
My opponent was a man, and he wasn't used to the idea that a woman would decide to be president of the union. According to him, women were unable, and in times of crisis, were not brave enough to take on that role.
The teachers saw Maria Teresa's work and dedication, and she won the election in a landslide, and later became the first woman president of the Dominican Teachers Union, and was chosen unanimously to represent Latin America for Education International, which unites 30 million education workers in 173 countries. This was an incredible accomplishment, explains her colleague, Rafael Félix.
El 75% de la matrícula de la Asociación Dominicana de Profesores. 75%
of the members of the Dominican Association of Teachers are women.
El 30%
However, less than 30% are part of the leadership. So there is a terrible inequality that an organization that is made up mostly of women would be led by men.
As president, Maria Teresa led the teachers in the struggle for better working conditions. She fought to increase public school funding, implemented needed reforms within the union, and she made sure that gender equity would be incorporated as an important value across the union and in the classroom.
Gender equity for us is a strategic issue. It is fundamental. It is part of our agenda, part of all our activities.
But what about at home? Does a prominent union leader like Rafael also apply these principles with his own family?
Yes, of course, I also go into the kitchen. I clean, I make the bed. We have a schedule in our house and we all participate.
As they encourage more women to take on leadership roles, the Dominican teachers also want to make sure this effort of inclusion will be felt within the rest of society.
When I go before the press and the public, I demand that they talk about the female as well as the male teacher. I demand that when they speak about the men, they also speak about the women. I support women as they break barriers, and I encourage women to support each other.
Transforming a world in which women face discrimination in wages and are excluded from leadership roles is a priority for Maria Teresa. This motivates her to work with educators across Latin America as part of the regional project on equality and gender perspective.
Our teachers are determined to break barriers, to increase the participation of women. Through Education International in the Latin America region, this program on equality and gender perspective has had an extraordinary impact.
The project unites 37 education unions in 19 countries as they support, encourage, and train leaders in their work to achieve quality education for all. Maria Teresa believes that as she fights for equality for women, she must also work to change the conditions of poverty, discrimination, and exclusion that so many children face on a daily basis.
Many of the children who live here have to get up early to go to work to support their families. This crushes one of the most important stages of childhood when they should be playing or going to school. The union must play a social role as well. The teachers must incorporate this reality into the classroom and mobilize for change. They must make the transformation of these conditions part of the education process in our schools.
The struggle for a more equal future will continue. The dedication and inclusive teaching approach of Maria Teresa and the Dominican Teachers Union can already be seen in classrooms across the nation. In the words of her own students, a new generation of leaders who believe in equality.
Los derechos de la mujer que deben ser respetadas por los demás, que no deben ser maltratadas, y que ella tiene los mismos derechos que tienen los demás.
Que no debe haber desigualdad en una pareja, porque deben ser iguales porque son trabajadores todos.
Las personas debemos ser iguales, hombre y mujer, debemos ser iguales porque somos iguales.
Que todos somos iguales. Si yo pudiera permitir que una mujer fuera presidenta, a mí me gustaría, me encantaría. Yo soy David Danilo Vargas y yo soy un líder.
Yo soy Estrella Isabel González y soy una líder.
Mi nombre es Madeline Ortega Martínez y yo soy una líder.
Mi nombre es Esmirna Cruz, yo soy una líder.
Mi nombre es Lendry Gómez y soy una líder.
Mi nombre es Brian Marconi Collante Sánchez y soy un líder.
Mi nombre es Maribí Tavares Pérez y soy una líder.
Mi nombre es Omar José Rosario Vázquez y soy un líder.
Me llamo Francesca Michelle Rosario y soy una líder.
Yo soy líder. Yo soy líder.